Hey everyone, welcome back. Hope you all had great holidays. This week I'm coming back with a new devlog for the tower defense collab game that me and paypercutts are developing in our spare time. This week I mainly worked on adding and implementing all the different textures and designs that paper cuts have made up for the game. The first thing that I worked on was adding this awesome looking flame turret animation into the game. I just added the textures, configured the animation for it, and added it into the game. So this is the first look at the flame turret and attack animation. I think it looks awesome. Props to paper cuts. Okay, the next thing that I did was I started to implement all the different death animations for different turrets. As I had a template done before, this was quite an easy task to do. Again, I imported all the different textures into the game and attached them to the current turrets. So now at this stage, every single turret and enemy have their own unique death animations implemented. Alright, after I had the animations implemented, I added an old type of a turret into the game that I honestly should have added at the start. So the new turret type is trenches. Basically, what me and paper cuts were thinking to do for this turret type, there's going to be a pre-built turret already existing on the map. Of course, this turret is going to be active and will be able to deal damage to the enemies. But just to make it more challenging, this type of a turret will be placed around the map and will be taking up a spot on the map, which means that the player won't be able to place turrets on top of the trenches. For now, I'm not too sure about the damage it will deal to the enemies. Me and paper cuts will have to do some good amount of game balancing in the future. Okay, so once the trenches were done, I moved on to work on some of the UI elements. I moved on to work on the shop UI. What I've done is I quickly added all the turrets into the shop's UI system. So now we can actually purchase, place and use all of the existing turrets. Later on, we will need to take care of the pricing logic as well. But this will most likely be done once we have all the basic features of the game implemented. Next, I have worked on a small fix for the path tiles. Before, we had these one color tile textures for the path. What I've done is I've added a new set of path tiles that paper cuts have sent me a long time ago. I quickly added into the Unity, and after configuring the tile maps, I have added it into the scene also. The last thing that I did this week was I have reworked the main wave spawning system. So before, what we had was that we could input the amount of enemies that we want per wave. Now these enemies would spawn randomly from the list of all enemies that we had. This was quite okay for the start and for testing purposes, but now we had to change it. And later on in the future, we will want more control over what kind of enemies spawn in each wave. So I quickly recoded the system and came up with a new one. Now we can choose how many enemies there's going to be per wave, and we can choose which type of enemies will spawn for that wave too. This will give us way more control over the game balance in the future. Now this is really all that I have done these past 2 weeks. It was the holidays, so I did not really have tons of time to work on the game. But I think we added some good amount of new things into the game. Especially, I'm really happy about the new wave system as it will be really useful in the future. As usual, I will be switching my development to the endless astronaut game that I'm currently developing in my spare time. We have the main features for the game already done, and I think for the next 2 weeks, I'll be working on adding new levels and probably adding some kind of a saving system also. Thank you all for watching. Be sure to follow my Twitter, Instagram, and join the Discord server. See you all in 2 weeks.